This video is brought to you by our partner, Florida PrePaid, who is committed to helping the next generation of STEM leaders and their families save for their future. To learn more about how to save for college, just visit myfloridaprepaid.com.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to the OSC YouTube channel. My name is Spencer, and today we're talking about one of my favorite topics, electromagnetic induction. Now, that sounds like a big, fancy, super complicated, sciencey word, but it's really not that hard to understand, and you probably use it all the time without realizing it. In fact, if you've ever been to Orlando Science Center before, you've probably used this really cool exhibit. It's called the Ring Launcher, it's in Kinetic Zone, and it's one of my favorites. It's obviously super fun and fantastic and really cool, but have you ever thought about why it actually works? Of course, you may be sitting there at home thinking, magnets! Thanks, Einstein. Yeah, but you'd be right. Magnets are involved. Well, kinda. Let's take a closer look at what's happening here. These are the rings that are being launched, and I happen to have this incredibly strong magnet here that I carry around for science. I'm kidding. Don't ever carry an incredibly strong magnet around, even for science. You'll notice when I bring these two together, there's no attraction. And that makes sense because the rings are made out of aluminum, which is not inherently magnetic. In fact, there are only three naturally occurring magnetic metals in nature, iron, cobalt, and nickel, and aluminum is not one of those three. In fact, I can prove it because I actually have a pair of scissors here that are made out of iron, and you can see they are indeed magnetic and they like to stick. So why is this non-magnetic metal being pushed upwards like a magnet? Well, it all comes back to that really cool phenomenon, electromagnetic induction. To understand why electromagnetic induction happens, we need to talk a little bit about electrons, which are these teeny tiny little particles that spin around atoms. We use electrons every day, like whenever we turn on the computer or our phones or our TVs or spam dances in Fortnite. The electricity that powers our electronics are just bajillions of electrons flowing down a metal wire. And flowing electrons are just called a current. Now, currents are really cool because they allow us to power our cities and go to Mars and play Fortnite, but they also produce a magnetic field, which means they pull magnetic objects towards them or push them away. Understanding why this happens is really complicated. It involves a deep dive into quantum mechanics and special relativity, which is literally the stuff that Einstein is famous for working on.
E equals MC squared!
Right, so it's a bit too much to talk about here today. All you need to know is that when electrons move, they create a magnet. We call that process electromagnetic induction. In fact, a more scientific way to say this is that an electric current induces a magnetic field. It also works in reverse. When you move a magnet near electrons, it moves those electrons around. And remember, moving electrons produces a magnetic field, so putting a magnet near electrons creates a whole separate magnetic field. So even when the metal is not normally magnetic, if we put a strong enough magnet nearby, it moves the electrons around and kind of turns that metal into a magnet momentarily. And we can demonstrate this with a copper tube and a magnet. Now, copper is not iron, cobalt, or nickel, so it's not normally magnetic. But if I drop this magnet through the tube, you see that it takes a really long time for it to actually fall through. That's because the magnet, as it falls, moves the electrons inside the copper tube, creating a magnetic field that slows the magnet down. Here we can see the same thing from overhead. The magnet is falling much slower than it would normally. We call the currents created in the copper tube eddy currents, and they are always counteracting the magnetic field that creates them.
And finally, I delved into the OSC fabrication lab and found this really heavy copper plate and an incredibly strong neodymium magnet. Now, remember, the copper plate is not magnetic, but the neodymium magnet has such a strong magnetic field that when I move it nearby, it induces a current in the copper plate. And that induced current creates a magnetic field that interacts with the original magnet to create some pretty fantastic effects. There is no video trickery happening here, it's just actual physics happening before your eyes. It's just electromagnetic induction.
Alright, so let's add all of this together and figure out what's going on with the ring launcher. When I press this button, it sends electrons through this coil, which creates an electromagnet. This moves electrons inside the ring, or induces a current, if you will. This induced current creates a separate magnetic field that interacts with the original magnetic field, and the ring is launched in the air. So the next time you're here at the Orlando Science Center playing with the ring launcher or in physics class or any other science museum, try and figure out why this happens. In fact, try and think about why things happen everywhere. Science is all about using your curiosity to probe why and how things happen. This is one of the reasons that I love science. You can keep diving deeper and deeper into a topic and unravel all kinds of amazing things. Like I said earlier, we didn't even delve deeper into how Einstein's work relates to all of this. The additive effects of a quantum spin and electron drift velocity result in relativistic length contraction of nearby positive ions, resulting in a difference in charge density that produces an electromagnetic interaction with property oriented magnetic dipole moment via virtual photons. Right. Thanks, Einstein. So I guess no matter how much you know, there's always something new to learn. So never stop being curious and keep probing what makes the universe do the amazing things that it does. Thanks again so much for watching. My name is Spencer, and we will see you next time. Thanks again to Florida PrePaid for sponsoring this video. Remember, to learn more about how to save for college, just visit their website at myfloridaprepaid.com.